And the Alliance for Rural Democracy are expected to march against the signing into law of the Traditional and Khoisan Leadership Bill and the passing into law of the Traditional Courts Bill. The organizations argue that the bills are unconstitutional as they will effectively bring back apartheid homelands by subjecting people to different laws in different parts of the country. Our reporter, Ofenze Sitimo, is covering the march and he joins us now live. Ofenze, someone who has not followed the story, could you please just give us background to what the story is all about?
Well, basically, thank you very much, Desiree. As you mentioned, that the Songket Gender Justice and the Alliance for Rural Democracy actually want these two bills not to be signed into law, basically because they feel that, rural customary law sometimes can be discriminatory towards women, and they say this might revert South Africa to the Bantustan laws, as it might subject people to different kinds of laws, as different chieftaincies might have different ways of applying the law itself. So they're saying that those rural leaderships should not be given the power in order to implement some of the laws that they would want to apply to their subjects. But joining me now is Lehloho Nolo and Tshepo from both Songke Gender Justice and the Alliance for Rural Democracy. Thank you so much for your time, guys. The purpose of today's march and why you feel it's important that the president shouldn't sign into law the two bills we spoke about.
So we've got the Traditional Khoisan Leadership Bill and we've got the Traditional Courts Bill, and effectively what these seek to do, as you've rightly pointed out, is bring us back to the Bantustan, so creating a different legal system for our family who live in rural areas, and we're saying we don't want that. For instance, when you think about Clause 24 of the TKLB, it effectively allows unelected traditional leaders to make decisions about land on behalf of the people with little or no consultations of the community. So we don't want that to happen, because what that means is that like the fight of Xolobeni would be reversed effectively by the passing of this law. So we want to stand against that and tell the president, please do not sign these laws into bill. We have one South Africa and everyone should be subjected to the same legal system. And yes, it is important for us to recognize that the leadership bill also recognizes the Khoisan people as a community. We definitely want recognition for the Khoisan people, but there are different ways in which to do this, and this bill in its current form is not the way that we want to. When we think about the Traditional Courts Bill, for instance, it basically sort of creates a court situation where people are not able to opt out of the system. So if you live in a rural community, you are subjected to this law. You can't decide you want to go to the magistrate's court, but there's no access, there's a prohibition of legal representation, so your rights to access to courts are infringed. We know traditionally that customary law is really bad towards women in particular.
Okay, thank you so much, my brother. Tshepo, if you can just elaborate on some of the challenges that this bill will actually pose, especially to the rural community, being the Alliance for Rural Democracy yourself.
So the first challenge that people are going to face is that their rights in order to make decisions on land and property and the transactions that happen will be diminished once TKLB can be signed by the president. In the sense that because of Clause 24, you need only consult with the affected people, not that they must give consent. And we are saying it's not only Xolobeni, it's been Grace Maledu in Bakgatla ba Leseding, many different communities, especially women, where we find that those insecure tenure rights under this bill, if it can be passed, they'll then be scrapped completely. Worst of all, we've had since 1996 the Interim Protection of Informal Land Rights Act, and we're saying IPILRA really gives people power. It says the rights holder should be the person who actually gives consent. Don't just consult with them, let them give free prior informed consent. And if we see just TKLB being passed, then we're going back in time. With respect to the Traditional Courts Bill, because what we're saying about Bantustan bills is, for as long as people are born into these former homelands, the geographic boundaries, then you find that democracy doesn't really apply to them. If we allow the Traditional Courts Bill to be passed, we're ultimately saying that people in rural South Africa are second-tier citizens. They don't have the rights to the courts like all of us. They may not even have the rights to gather the way we've done today.
If I may interject, so you don't think the two bills might pass the test of constitutionality?
Well, as the Alliance for Rural Democracy, we actually are a broad-based civil society and mobilization partner network. So we've got legal partners, we've got research partners, we've got mobilization partners. They are considering now, in the event that these bills are passed, what would happen next. But for us, this march is not to say we're not lawyers. We're never going to now say it's constitutional or not. But what we know is we have the right to say no. We have the right to decide on our future. We have the right to self-determination. And these two bills are going to take away those rights.
Thank you so much.
That was Tsepo from the Alliance for Rural Democracy actually saying that if the two bills are actually passed, they would take South Africa back to the dark ages of apartheid. And with that, back to studio.
An interesting conversation there. We will follow that story as it unfolds during today. Now, added financial burden as the price of fuel goes up again, as from midnight last night, motorists are paying 9 cents more per litre.